Find the mean, median, and mode. Let me get some more space here. So to find these, I'm going to first rearrange the numbers in least to greatest. We have 105 is the least. Then the next is going to be 124. And then we have 135, it looks like. 149. $165 and $166. I wrote these numbers too far apart. Okay, I rewrote them and wrote them a little bit closer together. And there's eight numbers here. There's eight numbers in our set, so I should have them all there. Now, to find the mean, all we have to do is add these up and divide by how many there are, which there's eight of them. Okay, plug that into your calculator. 105, 124, 135, 149. 65 and 66, 185, 192. I get 158.25. It says round to one decimal place, so 158.3. The median is the middle number. So we're going to go start from this end, go in one, in two, in three, and there is no median number. So we're going to take the average of these two numbers, so 149 plus 165 over 2. I get 157. That's the median. Okay, and what's the mode? The mode is the number that appears most often. There are no repeating numbers. That means there is no mode. Oh, hang on a second. I found my mistake. When I was typing in the average here, I typed in 150 instead of 105. And that gave me, when I retyped it in, I got 152.625. This is the correct number. Rounded to the one decimal place, it's going to be 152.6. That was my mistake. And that now that's all correct. Okay, find the same thing for this set of numbers. First, we need to write them all out. Let me do that here. Okay, I think I have them all written out. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 of them. And there's 10 numbers in our set, I believe. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yes. Okay. So the mean is just add them all up and divide by 10 since there's 10 numbers. Doing that, 7 by 4, 7, 8, 8, 5, 13, 11, 13, 43, 56, and 65, and then 97. Divided by 10, turn to one decimal place. It gives us 1254.1, which seems reasonable. 1254 is definitely somewhere in the center of these numbers. The median, we're going to go 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, and then we need to find the number between these two numbers. So 1185. Plus 1311 divided by 2 gives us 1248. The mean and the median are really close to each other, which is, I think is a good thing. And all these numbers, again, there's not any repetition, so there is no mode. And that's correct. Good. Last problem. Calculate the range and the standard deviation for the set of numbers. So the range is the smallest number, which looks to be 67, minus the largest number, which looks to be 90. So 90 minus 67 is going to be 23. Yep. And the standard deviation, you can do this on an Excel spreadsheet. If you click this right here, this is copy to a table. This is the Excel spreadsheet that I just copied this to Excel. And then we can do the actual calculation of it if you want. First thing we need to do is we need to find the mean. So we could say this equals the sum of all these numbers. Oops. So this just adds all the numbers up, 553. And this is going to equal this divided by how many there are. There's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 of them. That gives us the mean. Then we're going to take, this is going to equal each number and subtract it from the mean. That's the second step there. And do that for all the numbers. Oh, dang it, didn't want me to do the right one. Okay, so all these numbers have the mean subtracted from it. Then I'm going to square each of the numbers. Okay. Now I'm going to add them all up. Do it one more. It's going to equal the sum. I'm going to divide this number by how many there are minus 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 minus 1 is 6. And then finally, I'm going to take the square root. Square root. Dang it. S-Q-R-T this number here. And that gives me 8.679478, which is going to be 8.7. You can also just type in standard deviation. And I don't know what the difference between S and P are. P gives you a different number. It's based on the statistics. But you just take the standard deviation of these numbers. And you see we get the exact same number in one go. So a lot of the times we don't use calculators, or we don't do things by hand like this. This is definitely a thing for a calculator or like an Excel spreadsheet. It's much faster than doing all these steps. So 8.7, and that gives me the correct answer.